Being familiar with the symbol view is very useful when you're creating large designs with many subnetworks and components. The symbol view is a graphical tool that you can use to represent individual components in a schematic and subnetworks in hierarchical designs. When you place a schematic in another, ADS will prompt you to create a symbol. ADS will automatically generate a symbol for you, but you may want to draw your own, because you may want a symbol that better represents the schematic. Before we begin, note that there are a few parameters that you should follow in your design. Your overall length should be a multiple of 0.125 inches, and in addition, you should locate pin 1 at the coordinates 0, 0. Here I have a schematic with 4 pins. First, we need to generate a symbol for this schematic. Go to Window, Symbol, and a new symbol dialog will pop up. For the most part, these settings will be what you need to get started. At this stage, we have two options. We can completely draw from scratch, or copy modify an existing symbol design. We'll first take the ground up method. Click OK. Note that we have 4 pins on the schematic. Let's delete the auto-generated symbol design and work from scratch. Before we draw, let's make sure the preferences are set correctly. Go to Options, Preferences, then the Grid Snap tab. Note here that our units are set to 0.125 for X and Y. This means each of the dots are 0.125 inches apart, meaning our design will be a multiple of 0.125 if we design on the dots. Let's place pin 1 on the origin. Click the Insert Pin icon and place it. Don't worry about the numbered label. This will not factor into the length of the symbol. We'll now draw a polyline for the pin. While not necessary, it's nice to have a line from the pin into the component. Double-click to stop drawing. Let's now make a rectangle for the main body. Use the Rectangle tool. We can also draw custom shapes using the Create a New Polygon tool. You can also add power pins, called inherited pins, to the symbol. These will not appear in the schematic, but are added in symbol view. Note that the numbering for the power pin must be sequenced after all of your other regular pins. I'll quickly use polylines and pins to finish off this symbol. This time, let's modify an existing symbol design. Generate a symbol and go to Copy, Modify. Then select a device category that you want to create. I'll choose the amps category and select a regular amp. As before, I need to insert pins. The hotkey to rotate pins is Ctrl R. At any point, we can return to the generator dialog from the icon on the palette. I've saved the custom symbol design from the first example. When we place this component in a schematic, we see that the symbol design is used to represent the component. Thank you for watching this Keysight ESOF EDA tutorial. You can find a link to a free trial of ADS in the video description below.